It was just Tuesday night when Ted Koppel of ABC was in Atlanta telling the nation about the space shuttle launch from Cape Canaveral. What you see behind me now are the remnants of that telecast. It was Nightline coming live to you from our studio here at WSB-TV2. Their visit was part of a nationwide Nightline tour. What you saw was Ted Koppel. What you didn't see were the 44 people behind him. Recently, Special Edition visited the New York and Washington studios of ABC News. Tonight, we are introducing some of the Nightline staff to you in our behind-the-scenes look at the making of Nightline.
Tonight on Nightline, to have and to have not. Generalities are always misleading, but
this is the calm after the storm. And this is the storm.
Steve, can you call Octavia, please, and tell her she's got to pick up this line and talk to Pam? I don't know where she is.
Fine. You got it. It's just on top of it. Take it out. Take it out.
Mike Buddy seems to think there may be another uplink path out of there through Mexico City.
And getting from here to here takes a lot of time, manpower, energy, long-distance phone calls, and technology. Nightline is unique. It is the brainchild of ABC News. It started as nightly reports on the American hostage situation in Iran. And when the hostages came home, Nightline kept going. But there's more to it than that.
I think one of the best things about Nightline is that it is one of the only television news shows that really does what television is all about, and that is let picture tell the story. And when you have the freedom and the creativity to work with 5 or 7 or 8 or 9 minutes, then you can really do that.
We have an opportunity, because it is ABC News, to span the globe, to bring together via satellite conflicting ideologies, personalities, to illustrate either creatively or in a traditional manner a problem, to discuss it, to chew it over, and hopefully to let the public know something more about the subject than they did at 11:30 when they tuned in.
And in that half hour, viewers travel anywhere the experts and the news are, thanks to technology.
Well, literally, we're pushing the technology as far as it will carry us, whether it's the Khartoum live shot that we had, which had never been done before, or a live interview from overlooking Peking, or regularly being able to interview Vladimir Posner of Radio Moscow from Moscow. The fact that we can bring them together in a situation in a broadcast where they can discuss their divergent viewpoints is kind of extraordinary. And in fact, many of these people who come together on our broadcast would not sit down and have lunch together if physically they could, because they so strenuously disagree with each other.
And it works because of Ted Koppel. He uses skills gained over 18 years with ABC, from being their chief diplomatic correspondent in the State Department to reporting in Selma, Alabama, Hong Kong, Latin America, and Vietnam. His language skills are just as varied. He's fluent in French, German, and his native King's English. He dabbles in Cantonese, Vietnamese, and Dutch. He is a reader, 6 papers a day. He is an author, and he is successful by every standard but his own.
Well, because we have very shallow measures of success in this country. We measure success by how many people know who you are. I mean, some of the most successful people in the world are folks who spend their lives helping to feed the hungry, you know, helping the poor. They are not well known at all, with the exception of a Mother Teresa or someone like that. The measure of success in our business is how many people watch you. Well, by that measure of success, you know, Three's Company is infinitely more successful than Nightline. You can't allow yourself to get too seduced by those standards of success. I think there are certain issues which are important. The degree to which I'm able to convey information in a lucid, interesting manner so that people become better informed, that's the degree to which I'm successful. And I'm not yet sure, you know, how successful that is, and that's why I said the jury is out.
The great thing about Ted Koppel is he's a terrific, creative pain in the neck.
It was his idea to do a report on world hunger pegged to the international conference in Cancun. He called this a challenge assignment.
Everyone is concerned about world hunger. Everyone pays lip service to the notion that, yes, in the world as in our own country, there are the haves and the have-nots, and it's really tragic that there are people who are starving to death, but could we please not talk about it at the dinner hour? And I'm just about to go to sleep, so why trouble me with that kind of thing? So you have to find a way to take an issue that really is important and sugarcoat it to a certain extent.
He's even involved in selecting locations.
There's no way we could get a crew to Calcutta in time. I mean,
and he helps to line up the guests.
That's right. Yusufu represents African countries, and I think that is about as good a representative as you can get.
That was the afternoon conference call between the New York and Washington offices of Nightline. They start firming up the show. It is also a time to work out problems.
And so we're gonna need to have some sort of live flexibility. And in fact, I gather we're gonna pre-tape the interview. So
it would be awfully nice if we could just do the show. I mean, do the whole show at 10:30 and do it to time and
not have to worry about fitting in something at the last minute at 11:30. I mean,
you know, could we not go all the way through to the commercial, I mean, to the last commercial break, and then just tack on...
Sure we could, but you know as well as I do that that first spot is not going to be ready. It won't be ready.
At 10:30, it'll be ready.
If Frank's doing it, it'll be ready. I mean, we tell Frank it'll
be ready. It'll be
no,
ready.
No, it won't.
It is also a time to plan future shows.
All right, Bill, on that intelligence show we were talking about...
The show does one topic a night. Topics vary from the breaking news story of the day to issue-oriented topics to entertaining ones.
If we start to get too much up there on the pulpit, we're going to turn people off, and they in turn will turn us off. So I'm a pragmatist in that I realize that there are times when we need to entertain people also.
Ideas come from the staff and from viewers. Viewers mail about 200 letters a week to Nightline. Some have ideas, some want transcripts, and some are full of comments about the show or the talent.
Either that was awful or that was great. A lot of people write in with story ideas a lot more than you would think. Why don't you cover this and that? In my book, you are a dangerous, obnoxious wasp, something with Nazi tendencies, as befits your heritage, etc., etc. I can't really read the writing.
She puts the letters into categories and gives Ted the ones he'll personally answer. If enough letters come on one topic, a form letter is done. Then there are letters that require a little more, like this one on the country music show.
Conway had on a t-shirt with Tweety Bird on it in a cowboy hat. Tweety Bird has been my little girl's trademark ever since she was 4 months old because of the way she had us sitting and looking. Okay, I was wondering if you could contact Mr. Tweety for me on where he got his t-shirt and send me an address or where I could... I mean, this is the kind of thing that he gets. I mean, people write and want to get in touch with guests, but this is a first. We have never had anybody write in about guests' clothes.
Are you going to find a t-shirt for her?
We will try. This will probably not be our top priority, but we will try.
And this group will try anything because their motto is make it happen. It doesn't matter what the individual titles are, jobs overlap when needed.
We have the open all done already?
Yes.
You guys are great.
Richard Simmons, I want some natural sound. I want him exercising and singing.
Let's make sure the tape decides to record this.
Okay, well, are there people there at that earth station to convert it at 2 in the morning? Are they going to be there special for us?
Do you have a sense of how long you're going to want those things to run? Same thing?
No.
What, me?
So I felt sorry for that, and I wish I could send them food, potato chips, period. You love it? I love it. Goodbye. Okay, bye.
No one has any qualms about telling me how they think I should do my job, and I have no qualms about telling them how I think they ought to do their job. And so far, at least, it's worked out pretty well.
Denise Bailey, desk assistant, just out of Howard University, wants to be a reporter, but now does everything from sending scripts to New York to running errands. Nadine Mushin, associate producer who digs up the guests Ted wants and pre-interviews them to make sure they'll be good on the show. 45 people who live the slogan, make it happen.
A lot of times things happen very late on this broadcast, and there isn't time for the people that run the show to come down and explain to you, this is what I have to have and this is how you have to do it. So you have to be on a the same kind of a brainwave frequency as the person that you're working with, to be able to go to him and say, I have to have this, make it happen, and walk away. And be assured in your own mind that it's going to happen. And the people on this staff work so well together that if I say, go downstairs, cut me 15 seconds of voiceover, make it happen, it'll come out.
What often does not come out is the show planned. No show is set in concrete.
So even though we're on the air in six and a half hours, we're still not exactly certain of everything that we're doing.
Well, I can cite one example when we actually changed the show almost when we were on the air, and that's the night John Lennon was shot. And we had one show set to go, even as we went on the air with that show, we were putting in elements of that story as it was breaking, because it happened about a half an hour before we went on the air. So we can do it pretty late.
Then there was the night Moshe Dayan died. That meant all the work Jeff Milstein did on the original story scheduled went down the drain.
But you understand the nature of the business. We're in a news business, news changes. Unfortunately, Moshe Dayan passed away that night, and we had to go with that story because that was a much bigger story than what we were working on.
And part of the Nightline staff business is to watch World News Tonight together. The Cancun Report was their peg for the Hunger Report.
And if the underdeveloped world chooses to read more than Mr. Reagan's words about global negotiations than may be there, then both sides may be able to go away from this conference calling it a success. Sam Donaldson, ABC News, Cancun.
The working day for the Nightline crew is split into two very distinct parts. What you've just seen is part one. That's when the ideas and strategies are easily bantered about. That's when the show is still in an extremely fluid state. The atmosphere is so casual, an outside observer might find it hard to believe that these are the same people who pulled together America's Last Word in national news five nights a week. The best way to describe the pace is easy.
This is the news set for World News Tonight and Nightline. It's in the same building as the offices. But before they made the switch, they literally had to fight traffic to bring you the news.
That change in buildings also brought a change in tempo into high gear. We'll continue our look at the making of Nightline with a look at the humorous side of Ted and Treasury Secretary Donald Regan and what happens I think, when the guest is in Cancun and you can't get a picture.
Oh, Mike. NewsOps here says that the Mexicans tell them there is a fire in their Earth station.
Oh, that wait is going to be a thing of the past.
Back it up. Back it up. Music comes in by itself, okay?
From looking at this, it's hard to believe the Nightline topic is world hunger, but it is. It's just being made in the beginning a little easier to swallow.
Cheeseburger in paradise, medium rare with mustard be nice. Heaven on earth with an onion slice. Understand? Cheeseburger in paradise.
Eating everything on your plate is not going to feed one starving child in the world.
There is no script, just Ted's ideas transformed into pictures from Washington, England, and France.
I've got some guy saying something with a Cockney accent. I'm ready for something in French.
Frank and the editor have to make it sing, and in a hurry.
But we only have 36 minutes to finish. Neither of us were satisfied with that spot until we put the last shot in it. We both put the last shot in it. We both sat back and looked at it and said, you know, it's amazing how you can put a spot together and not know where it's going until you're finished with it. And when you're done with it, look at it and say, gee, that was really something.
So I feel sorry for them, and I wish I could send them some food and potato chips.
I'm not concerned about how I send them to bed because it's not my role to either be a tranquilizer for people so that they can go to bed thinking wonderful thoughts. Nor is it my concern to keep people up all night.
But maybe it's a topic that they need to be upset about.
That's why we, that's why we try to interest them in the subject. But the decision has to be theirs, not mine.
Steve Steinberg bangs out the copy for Ted to read. Ted and Steve share the writing responsibilities.
It's very hard to think like Ted Koppel. You simply don't. You try to think in terms of what he would want to say, how he would want to put it. But as I say, that's quite difficult to do.
Ted's a unique person. I've worked with him for about 18 years at ABC, and there are not too many Ted Koppels in this industry, and we're just delighted to have the Ted Koppel.
Tonight they plan to tape the show because Treasury Secretary Donald Regan has a dinner in Cancun. But then New York says...
Oh, Mike, NewsOps here says that the Mexicans tell them there is a fire in their Earth station.
Whenever we try to pre-tape, things go wrong.
They burn their uplink. I can't believe it.
In Washington, the hunt begins to find a guest to replace Regan.
Help me, somebody.
What? Where's Julie or somebody?
She's on the other side. All right.
No. Hold on, Denise. Get Dave L. on the phone. Tell him we need a car to go out to George Will's house right away. I mean, instantly. No, Julie is working on the guy in San Francisco. I don't know who
he is working on.
It's north of the district.
Just Marty Rogal, the guy in New York, is coming in.
Go. What is World Hunger Year?
Sounds like a job for Superman.
Okay, cross your fingers. We're working on some other possibilities, but...
Okay, and Mike Buddy tells us we have crews rolling to the fire at the Earth station. He'll cover it and put it on an airplane.
Okay. Tell him the bird came back.
We found another uplink, so it looks like we're going to try.
Tonight is an example of what happens a lot. You never know what's going to happen. You have to be flexible. You have to be quiet and try to take all the noise that's around you and figure out what you're trying to listen to.
No, that's in New York.
Need more ears, that's for sure. Because I can't hear enough. I don't have enough holes in my head to put phones in. And a couple more eyes wouldn't hurt either.
The picture is back, but now it's problem after problem.
All right. Now, we need for him to give us a count so we can sync the audio up with his video.
All right, Mr. Secretary, I'm going to have to ask you to do something now, just to count from 1 to 20, if you would. The reason for that is that your voice is reaching us at a different time than your picture.
16,
17, 18, 19, 20.
Almost.
That's the same test they put me through before they let me become Secretary of Treasury.
You may ask you to do it backwards.
The reality of this mess is that we cannot do the entire broadcast 5 minutes from now.
No, I don't know what we're... No, we're going
to... We're going to have to wait. We're going to have to do the damn thing live. We're going to have to apologize to the secretary, and it's still not ready to do it live because of the audio. And the video. What's happening with the video?
He said he was going to stay.
No. I know, but we are now 6 minutes away from live airtime, and we've got to start at the top of the show at 11:30 here. We go on live then, so I need to know what... Maybe we will push you up in the top of the show then so that we can get you out of there.
Yeah, it's in perfect sync, but we're literally out of time. Will he be patient?
What we would do is put you in after the first spot, and you would come 4.5 minutes into the show, and you would be out of there by 20 minutes off. In other words, 15 minutes from now.
That's all right. Go ahead.
Okay. Hey, CNN has pulled us off.
Okay, wait a minute. Wait a minute.
Michael, can we contact CNN person down there and ask them to wait until we are done with the scheduled broadcast?
Hey, Michael, we're coming up on 1 minute to air.
Who's worried about that?
Do you have an IFB drop there so you can hear the show?
57. Don't worry,
put it on the line. You met us.
I know how to rear up like that.
You know, we really have a problem in this country.
We find all the excuses in the world to stuff our faces.
When I'm hungry at home, I'm so used to going to the refrigerator and getting potato chips and stuff like that. But the other people, they don't have a refrigerator or anything to go get potato chips or anything. So I feel sorry for them, and I wish I could send them some food and potato chips.
Tonight on Nightline, to have and to have not.
Good evening. Mr. Secretary, we're coming to you in about 2 minutes. Can you give me a hello so we can see how the audio still is?
Hello.
You cannot hide from there.
Hey, that's not bad. Thank you.
I think the satellite sounds pretty good.
Standing by live now at the summit conference in Cancun, Mexico, is Treasury Secretary Donald Regan, one of the top U.S. officials attending the North-South Conference. Mr. Secretary,
seven, six, five, four,
page 11,
three,
two,
one.
Ron Robin, kill him.
Standing by live now at United Nations headquarters in New York is Ambassador Umaru Yusufu, the representative to the UN from the Organization of African Unity, which represents many of the developing nations in Africa. Mr. Ambassador, you...
Center up,
lose it. ...report for tonight.
20,
55. ...in Washington. For all of us here at ABC News...
155. And into it. Take it on,
This has been Nightline. For
ready to bring in the transcript.
...tonight's broadcast, send $10 to Nightline, Box 234, and Social Station, New York, New York, 10023.
Bring it in.
Nightline is a presentation of ABC News.
Okay, and we're away.
Thank you, guys.
Thank
very
you,
nice.
Folks. Very nice, everyone.
Very
thank
nice.
You very much.
Hey.
Woo!
Hey, Frank.
Yes?
Your band, great.
Thank you.
You took a bum couple
idea and made it fantastic. Thank you very much. A lot of kudos go to Gail, who did
some...
It was
a very fine show. In fact, Ken, we got quite a few calls, all positive.
Good.
It's a time for finding out from Cancun why Regan agreed to be late for his dinner.
Hey, Susan.
Yeah?
Go buy him a hamburger, would you please?
You know what? We have to pay it larger than that. I promised we'd do a tax show when they wanted to.
Oh, no.
Boring. They wanted to. All right. Hey, Willie, can we talk about next week so we can all go home?
Sure can.
But tomorrow, the crew in New York and D.C. will start all over to make it happen.
Eat your heart out 60 minutes.
Well, how do you do this, boys?
I've got to have somebody saying something in French.
Oh, he gets a ton of strange requests.
Hey, Stu?
It's 5:30 in the morning.
Hey, Stu? Stu, that's a good idea. We'll forget it.
Bob, make sure that burns.
Anything for ratings.
No.
So if you want to say anything nasty or untoward, get it out of your system now.
No.
Hey, Ted? I hate that idea. It's so good. Okay, we'll do it.
Showbiz is my life.